Hello everybody, happy Friday. Welcome to the BBC Learning English Live Friday Quiz. Now I'm your host Dylan and we have some great questions for you today. As always, we have vocabulary questions, grammar questions, idioms, phrasal verbs, and we have the director of some of your favourite BBC Learning English shows, such as the Grammar Game Show. Okay. So today's theme is television. Now let me know, do you learn English through TV shows and series? And what methods do you use to study through TV? So let's go and say hello to everybody. All right then, we've got Malai. I'm saying hello. And we've got Malai. Sorry, Malai, your name disappeared down the list. Hello, Malai. Sam is saying hello from Bath in England. Hello from Liverpool, up in the north of England. And we've got Fahan says hello from Pakistan. Hi, everybody. Happy Friday. I hope you're all excited, feeling good, and you are ready for the weekend. Now, this is the BBC Learning English Live Friday Quiz. So I'm just going to go through some of the rules and the guidelines that we do have. So, very simple. There are 8 questions. We do the questions first, and we do the answers later. So stick around for the answers because that's the important part. Next, it is just for fun. It's Friday. We all want to relax. We've all had a tough week, I'm sure. So we're just going to have a nice time together, have a quiz, test our knowledge. It's just for fun. There are no prizes. And third of all, if you are enjoying, hit that like button. Hit that like button if you're having a good time, if you're learning, and please comment and share. So if you think your friend, your sister, your brother, your father, your teacher, your student would enjoy this, please share it with them. Okay, back to the comments to take a look to see who is here today. We've got Margarita. Hello from Italy. Hello from the UK. We've got Tamal. Hi, Tamal from Bangladesh. And we've got Jafar from Sudan. As always, we've got a lovely international audience from around the world. I love to see it. So, hello, Vijay. Right then, let's get started with round one. And for each round, I will ring the bell to say there's a new round ready to begin. So, let's take a look at round one. Okay, and question number one is a vocabulary question, I suppose, and it's asking about the word current affairs. Now, what are current affairs shows about? A, news and society. B, celebrity gossip. C, romance. Or D, cooking. What are current affairs shows about? What do you think? So news and society, celebrity gossip, romance, or D, cooking. What do you think? So we've got Kramjit saying A. We've got lots of answers coming in. Lakshana going for A. Lots of A's coming in. We've got M going for B. We've got Mandalay going for A. So lots and lots of A's. Okay, so are you all correct or not? We'll find out later on. Let's move on to question number two. All right, on we go. Question number two. So, when TV is broadcasting live, we say it is A, in air, B, on air, C, under air, or D, with air. So we're looking for the correct preposition to go with this phrase. Is it in air, on air, under air, or with air? What do you think? So this is when you're broadcasting live on TV or on radio. Is it in air, on air, under air, or with air? And we've got a variety coming in. We've got Nangyalai going for A, in air. We've got a few D's. We've got Mustafa going for be on air, and Message going for on air. Okay, so lots of people go for the same answers today. We'll find out if they're correct later on. Question number three, on we go, flying through it. Round three. Okay, a round three is a listening question. So it's a little bit different to our normal way of doing it. I want you to say which of these is the correct pronunciation of this word. Okay, is it A, genre, B, genre, C, genre? One more time for this word. And this is like a category or kind of art, music, or literature. A, genre, B, genre, C, genre. Which is the correct pronunciation? A, genre, B, genre, C, genre. What is the correct pronunciation for a type of, it could be a type of TV show, could be a type of film, could be a type of art or type of book. One more time for you. A, genre, B, genre, C, genre. What do you think? And let's take a look in the comment section. We've got Linda going for C. Piotr, very, very confident. 100% C. We've got B. It's hard to pronounce it. Yes, this is a famously difficult word to pronounce. Which one is the correct pronunciation? Okay, we'll find out. So remember, stick around. We'll do the questions first, answers at the end. So stick around where we will tell you the answers. Round four, on we go. Round four. Ah, a bit of a grammar question here. Okay. Or I suppose grammar slash vocabulary. The actor, a spy who must stop the terrorist. Is it act A, B, plays, C, pretends, or D, performs? Now, I think this is a bit of a tricky question, but this is the word we use when people are, when an actor is trying to represent a character in a play or in a TV show or in a film. But what do we say? Do they act, play, pretend, or D, perform? What do you think? Ooh, and perfect. We've got a nice variety of answers coming in. They're flying in, so excuse me if I don't catch you all. We've got Rafika's going for D, performs. We've got Grace going for A, act. Tomohiro, B with a question mark, so maybe not so sure. And Books Overview also going for B, is actually going for C, pretends. All right then. So keep your answers coming in. And if you can make an example sentence with some of these words, even better. And I'll try and put them up on screen if I can. Right then, on to round five, which is my favorite round because we have a special guest. So who could it be? Dun, 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 dun. Hello, Peter.
Hi, Dylan. Hello, everyone. How are you doing?
Okay, I'm great. So this is Peter Price, director and TV producer. How are you today?
I'm very well, thank you, Dylan. Yeah, you're right. I've directed lots of the videos that you can watch on BBC Learning English. Some of them, a couple of examples. One of them is called English My Way, which is where all our actors exist in a sort of cartoon world. And I've actually found here some of the original artwork that we had designed. So our actors lived in this world. And we had to give them props as well. So we had, here's a clock, for example, from that series.
Nice.
And then I also directed the Grammar Game Show, which is
one of my very favorite English shows. A lot of fun. It looks like a lot of fun to watch. Did you enjoy making it?
Oh, it was a lot of fun. Yeah, we had a really good team of actors who played a huge variety of crazy characters. And we were in a dark studio for 5 or 6 days. And I think we all became slightly crazy by the end of it.
It comes across on TV. So, Pete, you've worked in TV for quite a long time. Do you think that learning English or language through the medium of television is a good way to study?
Well, actually, I really do think TV is a great way to study a language because I'm learning Dutch myself. I live here in the Netherlands.
I thought I knew a bit of Dutch, but it's gone.
You can say goedemiddag.
Goedemiddag, Piet.
Goedemiddag, which is good afternoon. Yeah. And so I watch a lot of Dutch TV and I watch it with the subtitles at the bottom. So you're hearing the language, but also you're able to read to keep up with what's going on. And I just think it's so useful because even if you don't know individual words or phrases, then there's so much visual information coming along that you don't have to wait long and then you can catch up with the story again.
Yeah.
And
you get your real life language as well. It's not textbook language. It's real language that people actually use.
Exactly. Yeah. And so my advice would be to find some programs that you particularly enjoy and then just, try watching them with the subtitles. So I'm very lucky because I love watching programs where people show you around their house and you can be really nosy by looking inside their house. So there's lots of those sorts of programs here on Dutch TV. And I watch them all the time.
Okay. As it happens, this week we've gone live with our new crime drama, Father and Son. So if anybody wants a good TV show to watch, check out Father and Son, bbclearningenglish.com. Now, Pete, I believe that you have a TV-related question for us.
I do, yeah. So here it comes. TV-related question. Which of these is a slang term for television? Is it A, Googlebox? Is it B, Gigglebox? Is it C, Gagglebox? Or is it D, Gogglebox?
Oof, tough question today, Pete. Could you repeat it one more time for the audience, please?
Of course, yeah. So which of these is a slang term for television? Is it A, Googlebox? B, Gigglebox? C, Gagglebox? Or D, Gogglebox?
Excellent. Pete, thank you so much for joining us today.
You're very welcome and good luck, everyone.
Have a lovely weekend.
Tot ziens.
Bye. All right. Okay. Thank you, Pete. That was Peter from the director of the Grammar Game Show. Thank you very much, Pete. Now, what do you think the answer to his question is? And let's have a look. Hannah's going for B with a big exclamation mark, a giggle box because it makes you laugh. Nora's going for extremely tough question. Good. I'm happy. A challenging question where lots of you can get to learn a new phrase. Now, this is a slang term that is quite common in Britain. I'm not sure if it's used in the rest of the world. I don't think so, but definitely in Britain, it's very common. So it's a nice little phrase to learn. And a variety of answers coming in. We've got Than going for A. Gina's going for D. We've got Yilin going for Google Box, which I believe was A. And we've got Chan Vasana going for B. So a lovely variety. And we've... Gulletin, never heard of before. Perfect. Then it's something new to learn for you. Okay, on we go to question number 6. All right, Dio. Okay. I love phrasal verbs. Students don't tend to love them, but as a teacher, I think they're fantastic. And we want this phrasal verb. So which phrasal verb means to watch a show? Does it mean, is it A, turn up, B, tide over, or C, tune in? So this is to watch a TV show. Or it could be to listen to a radio show. Is it A, turn up, B, tide over, or C, tune in? What do you think? Let me know in the comments section. Okay, we've got Ekta going for tune in, C. Pietro's going for A. And we've got Van also going for A. And JM going for C. So lots of C's, lots of A's. Sylvia is also going for A. And we got coffee with a nice guest. I guess it's tune in. Okay. Whoops. And IELTS Cusco is going for C. Sorry, so many comments come in. It's hard to keep track of them all. All right. So stick around. This is the BBC Learning English Live Friday quiz. Do the questions first, and we look at the answers later on. Round seven. Round seven question is, so very useful piece of vocabulary here. What is the device used to change channel called? And the answers are quite similar, but it's an important difference to get. Is it A, the remote control, B, the remotely control, or C, controlled remote? So similar answers here. Which one is the correct one? Can you get this correct? Because this is a very, very commonly used word. And we've got Zania, I imagine it's pronounced Zania. A, we got Dominica going for A. Lots and lots of A's coming in. And Visa Thun going for A. And Abdul Rahman going for A as well. And one more, Dr. Babika going for A. Oops, comments flying in. All right, and question number eight. Last question before we go on to the answers. Now, when we watch a sitcom, what are we most likely to do? Are we going to A, laugh, B, scream, or C, cry? So when watching a sitcom, what are you most likely to do? A, laugh, B, scream, or C, cry? Oh, it's so sad. So a sitcom, laugh, scream, or cry. And can you tell me, do you have any favorite sitcoms? And we'll look at the answer. I'll tell you mine at the end of the show when we look at this. Okay, I'll give you some nice recommendations for a sitcom. Lots of A's. Lots of A's coming in. We got Books, Overview going for Scream, DC going for A, Jasmine going for A. Not many people saying Cry. So A and B mostly coming in. Okay then, everybody. Well done for getting this far. So those are the questions. We're now going to take a look at the answers, and this is the important part. Now, if you can use any of these words, phrases, expressions in your own example sentences, please do put it in the comment section. And if you are enjoying the show, hit that like button, please. Share with your friends and comment. Let me know if you're enjoying the show. Hopefully the answer is yes. And if you'd like more content like this, you can check us out at bbclearningenglish.com. You check us out on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube, of course. So lots more learning English content is out there for you. On we go to the answer section. Question number one. What are current affairs shows about? A, news and society. B, celebrity gossip. C, romance. Or D, cooking. So a current affair show. And the correct answer is, of course, as many of you said, A, news and society. So a current affair show looks at the current events, the events that are happening now that are of political or social interest, and they're happening, you know, that day or that week or that month. So a TV show which looks at life and the big issues that we all face is called a current affairs show. Now, an affair is also a relationship between two people, one or both of whom are married or in a relationship with somebody else. So that's an affair. So I can see that some of you chose romance, and that was a bit of a trick answer to try and get you to say that. But it's actually about news and society and the big issues facing us this week, this month, this day. So well done. Did you get that correct? Let me know. All right. Okay, let me take a look. Okay, no problem. Okay, update. We got lots of comments coming in. Uzma, 1 out of 8, good start. And I'm right. Happy to hear it. Okay, 101, good start. Round two, on we go. And this was looking at when TV is broadcasting live, we say it is, and excuse the full stop there. Yeah, it shouldn't be there. When TV is broadcasting live, we say it is A, in air, B, on air, C, under air, or D, with air. So lots of B's, lots of D's coming in for this one. What do you think the answer is? And we got sounded very confident. I know it's on air. Now, are they right? Yes. Yes, as many of you got, the correct answer is B. Now, knowing your the correct preposition to choose is tough, and it's something that many students find difficult. But when we are saying that a show is broadcasting now, when it is live, we say it is on air. This applies to television broadcasting and radio broadcasting. And it comes from the very early days of radio, when broadcasts were sent out on radio waves. So they were literally on the airwaves. So we say on air because it was on the radio waves. Well done if you got that right. Has anybody got 2 out of 2? All right then. We got Hninsu. Well done, Sanu, 2 out of 8. Bananas, I knew it. And Isa going for B, well done. Iqbal, correct. Okay, good. You are right. Okay, on we go, round three. Our listening question. This was a little bit more difficult, I think, because I saw a wider variety of answers. And we were looking at this, the pronunciation of this word. And this word means, the definition is it's a particular category of art, music, or literature. So is the correct pronunciation A, genre, B, genre, C, genre, A, genre, B, genre, C, genre? What do you think? Now, this is a famously difficult word to pronounce, and it is quite tricky, as Luciana, if I can see your comment, that's tricky. It is a little bit, it's a quite difficult word to pronounce. And the correct answer is C, genre, with a J, J sound. Genre, genre. Now, some people will pronounce it genre. So genre or genre are both acceptable and correct ways of pronouncing this word, and you will hear both genre and genre. We do not say that. So genre or genre with a j, j, j sound, genre, genre, both are good. Now, that was a bit trickier. Did you get that one correct? And yes, very similar to the French. Thank you. Okay. Anthony, 2 out of 8, not bad at all. Okay. And we got Hector. What is genre? Okay. So a genre is a type of music or type of art or type of film or TV show. So for example, some genres of TV might include sci-fi, crime, reality TV, horror, documentaries, kids TV or children's TV. So, and genres of music might include reggae, pop, rock, rap, hip hop. So it's a certain type of music, art, literature, film, TV show. Okay, I hope that answers your question. And Omar, well done, I'm correct, well done. On we go to round four. This I like this question because, again, a wide variety of answers, because I think many of you are not quite sure about this one. So the actor, a spy who must stop the terrorist. A, acts. B, plays. C, pretends. Or D, performs. What do you think? The actor, a spy who must stop the terrorist. A, act, B, plays, C, pretends, or D, performs. Dun, dun, dun. The correct answer is B, plays. Now, this was a bit of a tricky question, but the verb that we use when an actor is in a TV show or a film and they're pretending to be somebody else is plays. So they play a character. Usually the verb play is followed by a noun which describes the character. So we could say, Tom Cruise is playing a spy in his latest film. Or Nicole Kidman is playing a murderer in the new TV show. So we say play, and then we use a noun to describe what type of character they are playing. Right. Did you get that correct? All right. Joshua, no problem. This was a bit of a tricky one. So we're here to learn. If you didn't get it correct, no problem. Just maybe write it down, note it, remember it, because that's why we're here. We're all here to learn. And okay. Did I give the answers away? Yeah, great. If I gave you a little clue, well spotted, Mahasan. Okay. Yeah, I got that true. So we wouldn't say I got that true. You say I got that correct. I got that correct. Or I got that right. As we got here, Sunda, I have got it right. Spot on. And Fernando, I'm right. Well done. And Gina saying, holy moly, I got it right. Well done. Okay, so you sound surprised. So well done, Gina. All right. And we've got a nice example sentence from Tony. It says, Loki plays Loki. So you usually put the actor's name, plays Loki in the video game that you play. So, you know, let's say Tom Hanks plays Loki in the video game I play. All right, okay. And let's have a look. We've got a nice question here. So some people say, why not D, why not A? Why isn't it act, or why isn't it performs? So we would say the actor is acting in a new show, or the actor is performing in a new show. But when because we've got spy, we're describing the character. So when we're describing the character, we use the verb play. So the actor is performing in a new show. He is playing a serial killer. So play describes the character. I hope that helps. Okay. Let's look. And it's not Tom Hanks, it's Tom Hiddleston. Okay, just an example I made up. Okay. Plays a role. So the actor plays a role, absolutely, Luciana, or plays a character. Very good. And perform, yes, you're right. Perform more commonly used when they're performing in a theater, in a play, or a live show of some sort. Yes, definitely. Oh, and Carol's give a very nice definition. Play a role and act in a show. Absolutely. Well done. Okay, on we go. Round five. Round five was Pete's question, which I know was tricky for many of you. So this is a British slang word, okay? And it's a slang word for television or telly or TV. But is it Google box? Is it giggle box? Is it gaggle box, or D, goggle box? What do you think? Which one is the correct choice? Google box, giggle box, gaggle box, or D, goggle box? Now, if any of you live in the UK, you might know there's a famous TV show with this name. So that might give you a bit of a hint if you possibly live in the UK. And we've got lots of answers coming in. A, B, 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 A, C, D. Nice variety. Okay. And we've got Hector. What is slang? So slang is an informal word that we use in spoken English It's a word that we use with friends and family, but we don't use it in formal situations. Okay, so this is a word that you wouldn't find in a textbook or in academic writing, but it's something that you would hear commonly between friends and family. Now, what is it? A Gogglebox, A, Googlebox, B, Gigglebox, C, Gagglebox, or D, Gogglebox? It's quite tough, huh? The correct answer is D, Gogglebox. Now, thanks to Pete once more for asking this wonderful question. And this, so a Gogglebox is a British expression used to describe the TV or the television. It's a little bit of a negative term. And you, like for me, I would often hear it from my parents. For example, stop watching the Gogglebox. Go outside and get some fresh air. Or they might have said, you shouldn't spend so much time watching the Gogglebox. It'll make your eyes go square. So it's a bit of a negative word. Wouldn't want to say that TV is not good for us or that it doesn't have, like, you know, high processing power in the brain when it's just watching junk TV. We say we can call it the Gogglebox. Okay, we're on. Okay, nice question. Goggle. Okay, so goggle itself is, it's an old-fashioned slang word for to look at something, to watch something. It's like ogle, or to stare, and to be quite rude in your manner of looking. It's not a word, we don't use this verb much anymore, but it was a bit more common in the past. But it means to look. But more commonly nowadays, we use the word Gogglebox. There is a famous a British TV show called Gogglebox. So it's very much in the zeitgeist. People are talking about this quite a lot nowadays. All right. And yes. So we do have the expression, if you watch too much TV, you get square eyes. Yeah, that's definitely a British expression as well. Joshua, 4 out of 5. Waste time is Gogglebox. So the Gogglebox is used to describe the TV, but you might hear the expression from parents and from certain people saying, don't waste your time watching the Gogglebox. Huh. Yes, and of course, goggles also has the meaning of glasses, and in particular, it means swimming glasses. So the glasses that you wear when you're swimming, that go around the face like this, around the face and head, we call them the goggles, from the same origin. Okay. All right then, 5 out of 8 from Uzma. Coffee, very nice. First time to hear it. Perfect. It's a new expression for you to learn and use. Okay, is telly with a double L, T-E-double-L-Y, a British slang for TV? Yes, it is. It's very, very, very common. So TV and telly, I would say they're used about equally, in that you just hear it every day, you hear the word telly. So T-E-double-L-Y. Kim, great point. Thank you very much for commenting. Okay, all right. Let's move on. Mahasan, okay. All were correct, so you're more of a TV expert than a sports expert. Good job. All right. And nice question from Heyman, saying, can we use Gogglebox in positive situation? Yeah, we can, but it's not a particularly word, a particularly positive word. So we can say, yeah, let's put on the Gogglebox. But it's got a slightly negative implication or connotations. It's not a very positive word, so we could, but 95% of the time it's used in negative situations. Okay, all right then, round 6, on we go. Phrasal verb question. So the phrasal verb, which so if you would like to learn more phrasal verbs, please do check out our Instagram, Facebook and Twitter pages, where every Friday morning we've got a brand new phrasal verb table for you, with lots and lots of different 5 phrasals every Friday. It's really nice, really nice image. Great way to learn. Let's learn this one. Which phrasal verb means to watch a show? A, turn up. B, tide over. C, tune in. What do you think? A, turn up. B, tide over. Or C, tune in. Dun, dun, dun. Yes, I saw many people get this one correct. It's a little bit tricky, a bit of a variety of answers, but lots and lots of C's coming in. And the correct answer is C, tune in. So this is another expression that comes from the olden days of radio and TV. So lots of our TV and film vocabulary come from the early days of TV. And even though we don't do that particular thing anymore, the word has stuck. So back in the day, 80 years ago, 100 years ago, with your TV, you'd have to tune in or find the station. So this could be with your TV or with your radio. And with your radio now, maybe you just turn the knob to find the channel you want. So this is called tuning. So to find your show, you have to turn it and tune in to your favorite show. So the saying is stuck, and it now means to watch a TV show, or it can mean to listen to a radio show. It's used by hosts and presenters to say, tune in next week. So quite commonly used like this. To turn up means to arrive. So for example, I turned up early to the train station because I wanted to get a good seat on the train. Or to tide over is when something has helped you through a difficult time. So for example, I ran out of money 2 days before payday. Oh, what can I do? My friend gave me a small loan to tide me over, to get me through that difficult time until payday. So it's when you have something that helps you get through a period of time, usually quite a short period of time, until the situation is sorted. Now, did you get that correct? Okay. We got a happy, well done, okay. I'm happy for you. Nice example from Prashanth. He hasn't turned up for my party, so that's with turn up. Very good. Oh, we got somebody else who's a phrasal verbs fan. Perfect. Okay. Let's look. Okay, so tune in. Tune in with us. Tune in to us. Tune in with us. I think we don't need to use with us, okay? Tune in. Ha 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 ha. Okay, so tune in we use when you're telling somebody to start watching. And if you want people to continue watching, we use stay tuned. Stay tuned. There's plenty more answers to come in our BBC Learning English Live Friday quiz. Thank you, Joshua. And okay. And can we use this in an informal conversation? Absolutely. 100%. Okay. Good. So nice question. Okay. Nice example. Please turn up your TV. Turn up the volume. It's time for my favorite sitcom. Tune in. I love it. Lots of examples from today's show. And turn up can mean, it's got many meanings, as phrasal verbs do. It can mean to arrive somewhere. I turned up at the party early. It can mean to put the volume up. If you can't hear me, turn up the volume. Okay. So those are two of the meanings. And let's have a look. Primavera is asking, can you give an example with this phrasal verb? Yes, I can. So, so next Friday, we will have another live English Friday quiz. Please tune in at 1:30 on Facebook and YouTube. Okay. And can I say, let's tune in. Yeah, we'd say, let's tune in to a K-drama. Let's tune in to a K-drama. Yes. Normally we'd be quite specific. So you can say So I think with tune in, we would often use it as a command. Tune in next week. Or we can say maybe for plans. So What are you doing on Friday? Oh, I don't know. I'm relaxing. Maybe I'll tune into a K-drama. Something like this. All right, moving on, guys. On we go to round 7. Okay, if you are enjoying, please hit that like button. Please share. Please comment. You know the drill. Oh, a bit fast there. So a little bit of a clue for everybody. But I noticed that many, many of you got this right. I was quite impressed with you. Well done. Okay, so we've got, what is the device that we use to change the channel called? Remote control, remotely control, or C, controlled remote? And okay, and I'm gonna go quickly back, so let's have a look. We've got a question, Zao is asking about the last question. Is it the same with stay tuned? So tune in means to start watching. Stay tuned means to continue watching. Okay, well done. So A, lots of you got this correct, mostly A's, okay, because this is very commonly used. And I've heard many of my students call it by the wrong name. So I'm a little bit surprised how many of you got it right. So well done, because yes, the answer was A, remote control. So the device we use to change channel is remote control. It's a wireless device. It does not have a wire. And we can change channels, turn up or turn down the volume, turn on or turn off the TV, and much, much more nowadays. Often, people will shorten this to just the remote. Pass me the remote. My favorite TV show is starting. Okay. We can also use remote to describe the controller we use to, like, with the wireless toy car or a plane or the ships that children often have. When you got a little controller here, we call that the remote control. However, we don't use this word to talk about, let's see if I've got one here, to talk about controllers for gaming consoles. We call these controllers. So this is not the remote control, this is a controller. Controllers are for TV and for children's toys usually, and we call them remote control plane, remote control car, remote control ship. All right, so let's have it. Okay, a lovely example. There is a war in my family because of remote control. I'm sure many families are very familiar with this. Han, can I say remote instead of remote control? Absolutely, it's very common to use remote. Okay. Remotely, so online, not usually, it usually is for the TV or the DVD player, maybe. Okay, where did you hide the remote control? A very common sentence I hear in my household. Yeah, good. And coffee, nice question. No, I'm not familiar with the word telecommand. Okay, I first time for me to hear it, so I don't think we use that in English. Okay. Somebody has spotted PS4. Yes, it is a PS4 controller. All right. And let's have a look. Well done. Nailing it. 7 out of 8 already. Impressive, because there's a few tough ones today. All right. And I feel your pain, because this is when this happens, it's not a good day when you cannot find the remote control. All right. And the last question of all. Okay, so last question of the BBC Learning English Live Friday quiz. I hope you're having a good time. If you are, hit that like button. We have plenty of live shows for you. If you enjoy this, check it out on Mondays, 1:30. We got Phil is hosting the vocabulary class. Tuesday and Thursday, Pronunciation Live with Catherine and Ian, 1:30s. And on Wednesdays, we have a grammar class or an English class about various topics, different topic every week, 1:30 on Facebook, on YouTube. And Fridays, you know what happens on Fridays, it's the live Friday quiz. All right, last one, and I think there's not the most difficult question. I think lots of people are coming in with the correct answer for this one. Is sitcom? Now, if you got the correct answer, what did the word sitcom mean? Sitcom is two words put together. Okay, what do you call this. So it's like a portmanteau of two words put together. Sitcom. What are those two words? All right, and it's like A, laugh, 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 laugh. Lots of you, few B's, few C's, but mostly a laugh. And you are correct. It is laugh, and we've got vu. Very good. Very, very good. Situational comedy. Okay. So, sitcom is a situational comedy, as vu has nicely said. This is a genre of comedy that's based around the same characters every week or every episode, every show. And it's got a storyline that continues. This is in contrast to other types of comedy like stand-up, where a comedian tells jokes, or a sketch comedy where actors play different characters and they're kind of unrelated. So situational comedy is when it's the same characters every week and the storyline goes on. So the most famous one of my lifetime is probably Friends. So Friends is an example of a sitcom. Other famous American ones are Big Bang Theory and How I Met Your Mother. But I prefer British sitcoms. Fawlty Towers, Old But Gold, very, very good. I'm Alan Partridge is my favorite one. And then there's the fantastic BBC sitcom called The Office with Ricky Gervais. If you have not seen any of those, I highly recommend it. British comedy is often a bit more awkward and uses lots of clever wordplay. Honestly, check those shows out. So, did you get those correct? Let's take a look here. Okay. Nice. Okay. It's a comedy about daily life situations. Absolutely. Okay. So, British sitcom, it's very old now, but Fawlty Towers is great. What else is a good one? We got somebody else saying, I love The Office, Fawlty Towers. Really good. Okay. Coffee, thank you for the comment. My name is Dylan. Okay, so I'm Dylan, but thank you. It's my Friday shirt. Get me in my Friday mood. Okay. So what's the difference between a film and a TV show? A film is usually 1.5 hours to 2.5 hours, and it's a one-off usually. It's a self-contained story. The whole story happens within that 1 or 2 hours. A TV show has a number of episodes, and usually they come out every week. So you watch one, let's say every Thursday, you watch it every single week, and the story goes on over multiple episodes. Okay. All right then, let's have a look. We got, you are not bad at all. 6 out of 8 is pretty good. Because it means that you got lots of them right, but you also got room for improvement and you can learn something new. Well done. Estella, 6 out of 8, better than last week. Good job. Very, very good. And let's have a look. Colorful Friday. Yes. You got to get in the mood, haven't you? You got to loosen up, relax. Friday's coming. The weekend is coming. So you got to get yourself in a good mood by wearing a nice, colourful shirt. All right, then. Yes, I love sitcoms. I love comedy. So I love a good laugh. Game of Thrones would not be a sitcom, but it is a TV show. But because, well, when I watch it, I don't laugh too much. It's quite a dark show. Yeah, all right, then. Yes, Hannah, film is in the cinema. Yeah. So a good film is in the cinema first, and then it comes on TV later on. All right, then. Natha, 5 out of 8. Well done. Good night. Have a nice evening. Thank you for joining. Joshua, 7 out of 8. Very good. Alicia, 5 out of 8. And you learned something new. That's what we love to hear. Thank you so much for joining. Okay, so Walking Dead. What is Walking Dead? Maybe just a drama. We'd call it a drama, or maybe a dystopian drama, or like a zombie drama, or we can call it an apocalyptic drama because it's about the end of the world or something catastrophic has happened. So apocalyptic is one word, or just a drama. So good. Okay, let's have a look. Layla, thank you very much. Thank you for joining. Yes, Prashant, every Friday, 1:30, it's either me, it's mostly me, sometimes Rob, every Friday, here to improve our English and to have a nice time, a nice relaxing time, hopefully. I hope you enjoy. If you are, hit that like button. Everyone does help. Trust me, it really helps, okay? And we've got Hector, didn't get full marks, but you're here to learn, okay? That's exactly it. It doesn't matter. It's not a competition, okay? It's, we're here to learn. We're all learning a language. We want to get better. We want to improve. So if you got 1 out of 8, well done. You got 1 and you learned 7 things. If you got 7 out of 8, well done. Okay. It means that you're on track and you can reinforce those words, those idioms, those expressions. And as always, test your listening. Okay. So we're going to finish up very soon. But Hung, see you next week. Good, I had a nice comment from Coffee. It was worth tuning in. Oh, I love it. T-U-N-I-N-G, one N in tuning in. Very, very good. Glad you enjoyed. And let's have a look. Any more questions coming in? Lots. Okay, no more questions, but lots of people saying you enjoyed. Thank you so much for joining, everybody. Have a lovely weekend. Happy Friday. Okay, and pop on a nice, colorful shirt and enjoy yourself. All right, bye-bye. See you next Friday, 1:30, for the BBC Learning English live quiz. Bye.